Hello and welcome to the first episode of the Kingfisher Knits podcast. My name is Madeline. You can find me on Ravelry as Madeline Windsor, all one word, all small letters. And you can find me on Instagram as Kingfisher Knits. I also have a website, madelinewindsor.com. And I also have a group on Ravelry, which has just been started, which is the Kingfisher Knits group. And that is where I intend to put my show notes. I warn you now, show notes will probably always be limited, and videos are going to be recorded and uploaded, and I do not have time for post-production. This is one of the reasons that I didn't start a podcast, because I have a very busy life. So I'll give a little introduction. I live in Zurich with my family, Zurich, Switzerland. I don't have any family nearby, and I have two small kids. My husband has a full-time job. I have a job, and to be honest, my free time is pretty limited, and when I have free time, I like to spend it knitting. So I kind of thought, well, I can't do a great podcast like the podcasts, which I love and watch every week. And then I just thought, well, I'd like to try. And even maybe this will just be one episode, and it may be a very long time till another one comes along. But I've just loved so much the knitting community, the online knitting community, all the people I've met, and everything that they've given me. Well, all the support, you know, you feel that you get. And I just wanted to also engage. So here goes. A little bit about me other than my family. I am a very keen knitter. I do also crochet a little bit, but knitting is my main love. And I am a knitting designer. I don't have a huge amount of designs out, I will say, but I mean, it's something that I'm doing. I spend quite a lot of my time doing, and also tech editing knitting patterns for other designers. And I love all of that. I would love to make that, you know, have an utterly central role in my life. To be honest, it does have a very central role in my heart and in how I think about approaching my days and my weeks, but it's not the only thing that I do right now. So I wanted to start out by talking about finished objects. I could obviously show you all kinds of things that I've finished in the past, but I'm going to try and maybe show some of those in future episodes as and when it comes up. And for now, I'm going to show you what I actually did finish in the last week or 2 weeks. I already forgot when I finished it. But I mean, if you check my Instagram, I posted a shot when it was blocking. So that's when I finished it. Anyway, and I'm wearing it right now. It's a cardigan. The design is the Soubrette cardigan by Mary Annarella. You can find it on Ravelry. It's a paid for pattern. And it is a lace weight cardigan with sort of elbow length sleeves. It's a seamless design. I'll just stand up so you can see it's got this sort of little garter and lace edging at the front, and it's sort of a waterfall cardigan, but instead of having sort of these bigger front panels knit, which is kind of common for a waterfall cardigan, it adds the extra fabric sort of here, more on the side, but when you wear it, it still has that nice fluttering hang to it. And what I really love also is this detail, so it comes from the way it's constructed. You get this line here across the top, across the back. This is the first adult cardigan that I ever knit, and it's lace weight. Guess I'm a glutton for punishment, but I mean, this was a project, a long-term project for me, something that I knit on as and when I could. And to be honest, I don't feel like the actual knitting of it took very long. I really loved working on it. It was worked on 3.25 millimeter needles. You can find all the details on my Ravelry project pages, which when I put up show notes, I will at least link my project so you can see the details. I'm fairly good at least putting all the basic information on a project, so what needles I used and the yarn and what have you, but sometimes I don't have very extensive notes, especially not if I didn't alter the pattern. This, I don't think I altered it at all. There are some bits where it tells you to link, you know, knit for a certain length, and maybe, you know, you knit a centimeter more or less. But I just love it. I saw it. I did actually see Mina of the Knitting Expert podcast, who knit it, funnily enough, in grey. But honestly, when I bought this pattern, I didn't connect that that was the pattern that Mina was knitting, even though she was knitting it at the time. And then as soon as I downloaded it and then I watched her next podcast and she was working on it, I realized that it was the same. And then I went and bought yarn for it and I came out with grey, which is strange. I don't wear a lot of grey, but I just couldn't resist. So this yarn is really lovely. This yarn is from Knitting in France. She's an indie dyer. She's on Etsy. And I bought two skeins because of the yardage. I think that it said for my size was between 11 and 1200 yards. And this is lace weight, 800 meters per 100 gram skein. So I bought two skeins, but actually I've used like maybe only 15 grams from the second skein. So this will be enough to make probably a decent size shawl or maybe a lace top, a little something. Anyway, I love this yarn so much. It is, hopefully you can see the sparkle there. It is 75 merino, 20% nylon. So, you know, I was happy about that because I knew it would be strong even if I was making it into a garment, and 5% sertalina. And it is so soft, so soft. Oh, and it's still got that nice warmth to it. You know, you feel a bit of warmth. It doesn't feel like you're wearing cotton, but then it's lace weight and I just love it. And I am going to be wearing this to a wedding that I'm going to at the end of this month in Portugal, and I just couldn't be happier. I did swatch when I started off, you know, once I decided to do this design, so I've still got my little swatch here, and you can see here when I changed needle sizes, smaller and larger needles. I can't remember now which was the one I finally used. By the looks of it, probably the larger needle size. But I do think it's really important to swatch for your gauge. Maybe that's also because I'm a designer, and so I always worry that people don't swatch, and then might end up running out of yarn or something. I mean, for accessories and what have you, sometimes it can be less of an issue, but certainly for garments, it's really necessary if you want to know what you're getting and if you want to be confident of how much yarn you have. Anyway, this is just to show you the pattern. I mean, it's all beat up now, but this is it, you know, for example, in another colour. Sorry, it's all backwards on my screen. I feel like the grocery girls. I don't know if it was backwards when I load it up. Probably not. No, it's just me being silly with my left and right. Oh. Anyway. And that was living in this lovely project bag, which I have from the Plucky Knitter. The stuff's all still in there. I need to clear it out, put the project bag away and what have you. But yeah, it's only been about a week. So anyway, so that's my only real proper finished object for this episode. That being that it's the only object that I finished recently. But I do have two other things that I wanted to show you. The first one is this lovely shawl here. I did not knit this shawl. What happened, so first I'll tell you the design. This is the spring into summer shawl. Sorry, it starts up here. Which is designed by Mina of the Knitting Expert podcast. And I test knit this pattern for her. And it's a wonderful pattern. I'll say a little bit about it in a minute. But I wanted to push myself. I had a mini skein kit from the Knitting Goddess. Unfortunately, I have nothing left. I used every single last bit of the yarn, so I can't show it to you. But you can find the project page, and I will link the project page, so you can see the colours that it was. It was like the kit was called Chili Pepper or something, and it was reds and purples. And I loved them. I thought they looked fantastic, but I don't wear those colours. Like, I hardly ever wear red. I do occasionally wear purple. But yeah, I mean, I just loved how they looked, but I was very suspicious while I was knitting it that I was not gonna wear it. I paired it with a cream, just a plain natural undyed yarn from Wollmeiser. And anyway, I just decided, fine, I'm doing a test knit. It's fine, and if I don't like it at the end, not the design, I mean, at all, the colours, then I can give it away. I'll just give it to one of my friends and who loves those colours, and they'll be very happy. Anyway, one of the other test knitters was Shauna. She's Shauna Knits on Instagram. Again, if I remember, I will link that. And she test knit it in these colours, and these are my colours. So I commented, oh my gosh, that's so beautiful, it's so my colours, you know, I've picked colours which are out of my comfort zone, but it's fine. And she was like, oh, I love yours, why don't we swap? So we did. She lives in America, and she posted, once she'd finished this, taken her photos and everything, she shipped this off to me, and it arrived, and it's enormous. She had more yarn than me. And she even included the leftovers with it. So this is made with the main colour here, this beautiful green. It's Wollumwein yarn. I don't have any Wollumwein yarn. Now I do. It's already knit, but I have it. And this is her Footsie base, which is her 80-20 BFL nylon in the succulents colour. And I've always loved the succulents colour. So honestly, amazing. And in this case, the mini skein kit that she used is from Wonderland Yarns. It's the same, not the same colours, but the same kit that Mina used in her shawl. This is the Cheshire Cat sock yarn, which is 100% superwash merino. And this colour combination was called Along the Beach. Here it says it was a limited edition, so I don't know if you can get this anymore. These are not yarns that I've ever bought. Anyway, I love it. And this, so as I said, this shawl pattern is called Spring into Summer. And it's a great pattern because you can, it's designed to obviously use a main color and minis, but you can decide, you know, how much yarn you have, how many repeats you work of each pattern, and maybe you do less of this textured part if you have less minis a bit, and then you have the lace and you end up with a smaller shawl, or you do less lace if you don't like lace, or you do more lace. It's really, really a great pattern. She gives you wonderful instructions on how to customize it, and I know I just keep showing it and holding it out, but I just can't help myself. It's just lovely. Anyway, so that was really cool, and I sent off my one to Shauna. I don't think it's arrived yet. I sent it off much later than she sent hers due to various complications, but anyway, hopefully she will get that soon. And the final sort of full knitted item I wanted to show you is one of my designs. It's my latest design. I released it yesterday, and it has been a fantastic collaboration with Nora George Yarns. Nora George Yarns is run by Tracy. It's an indie yarn, she's an indie dyer in the UK, based in Leicester in the UK. And I will link her, of course, but if you want to check her out, you just go to norageorgeyarns.com. And all her info is there. Anyway, I've long loved Tracy's yarn, have purchased a fair few skeins, and I particularly was always in love with a colour that she had called Expecto Patronum. I'm a Harry Potter nerd, fully confessed. I'm sure I'll talk about it more another time. But even aside from the name, just love this colour. And I had said to her, what do you think about doing a design collaboration, and maybe if I can do a shawl design with two colours, and I would love to use Expecto Patronum, and maybe you can do a coordinating tonal colour. And that's what she did. And this is the design I came up with. So I'll explain in a little second about the construction, but it's easier to show it this way across. So you cast on here. I can't remember now if it's 5 or 7, a few stitches. And you're knitting all the way up to here, you're always increasing, and then you're striping in your tonal colorway. Then you stop increasing, you have this section in the middle where there's no increasing. You first work this really simple but so lovely lace in one color, some more stripes, lovely expansive Expecto Patronum, my favorite color. And then this beautiful lace pattern again, and then you start to decrease to get back to the other point. I like many different shawl constructions, and I have knit shawls with the classic top-down construction where you end up with hundreds of stitches on the needles, and sometimes that's fine. Sometimes that's kind of a bummer, and it feels like it takes longer, even if the number of stitches in the end total in the project isn't different. And I really love this construction, this type of, with this decrease line in the center that makes the, you know, how the lines end up. Oh, just love it. And I had that sketched out for a really long time, since, I don't know, autumn last year. And I wanted to do a shawl which worked like that. So you started with next to no stitches, you work along, you never have very long rows, and at the end you cast off, bind off, very few stitches. So it's a lot of garter stitch in here, but I'm for me at least, who is not the biggest fan of garter stitch, to be honest, it makes for such a wonderful texture though, and it it doesn't get dull because you're doing different things, you're changing colour, there's a bit of lace, and at least for me, it's my design, and therefore you might think I'm biased, that's fine, probably am, but I had so much fun coming up with this design. And then Tracy came out and did 5 more sets of colorways, which are absolutely stunning. You can check them all out on her website. Last night we did pre-orders and they sold out in about 9 minutes, which was amazing. Thank you so much if you bought one of those kits. Tracy does hope that she might do some more in the future, but she's not committing to anything right now. She's got her plate absolutely full. Of course, you can knit it, you know, from any 2 skeins that you think go together, you can still knit this design. And to that end, I just wanted to mention I just started a cowl. Well, the cowl hasn't started yet, but there's a chatter thread up in my Ravelry group, and the cowl will be for this shawl. It sort of officially runs from the beginning of May to the middle of June, but you can cast on sooner, so if you're not, you know, waiting for the kit from Tracy and you already have your yarn, you can get the pattern and cast on straight away. That's still going to be valid. Tracy will also be doing a cowl, so we're co-hosting this cowl, so to speak, and you'll get an entry when you post your finished shawl in the finished objects thread. And for me, you get a bonus entry if you use Nora George yarn, and that means also if it's not kit from this particular kit. So if you didn't get your hands on the kit, but you've got other yarn of Tracy's, then you can use that too to get another entry. And I'm totally fine with double dipping away if it fits with other, so if it's with the Harry Potter cowl that Katie from Inside Number 23 is hosting for the whole year. And I just wanted to quickly mention the yarn that I used for this it's got beautiful stitch definition, and it is Tracy's High Twist Sock Base, which is 80-20 Merino Nylon, and I just absolutely love this base. And this shawl uses almost the full skein of the speckle colour, so colour A, and up to 80 grams of the corresponding tonal colour B. But all those details are also on the pattern page. So you can see if you've got something that you think would work, if you want to join in, and that would be lovely. Then that finishes the FO and sort of admin section. And I just wanted to show you a couple of whips, really mainly one whip. Quite a few of the things I've got on the go at the moment are design projects, and most of them I can't show. What I'm always going to try and do, if I continue with this podcasting business, if it's not a design for a magazine or a yarn company where I absolutely cannot show it, I can maybe show off the yarn, but sometimes that's also not possible because if they send me a new yarn or a new colorway, I'm not allowed to show that. Sorry. But if instead it's design work for self-published designs, I will certainly show you the yarn that I'm going to be using, and possibly some in progress, but more towards when the at least my sample is finished. Anyway, living in this gorgeous project bag, which is of course from the lovely Mrs. Brown's Bags, this with a bee splat bag. I didn't get this in the kit update, but she had this also with the corresponding yarn, but I did get a bag when she did another one later. And I love it because it matches the yarn that I'm using. So this is the Meandering Shawl by Stephen West, which is a brioche, two-color brioche shawl. And that pattern, you can't buy the pattern. The pattern is in this book, which is from Loop of London. Such a lovely book. Such a lovely book. There are lovely patterns in here. This is the first one that jumped out to me that I knew I had to make. Some of the others, I'm not sure if I would really make them for myself, but either for gifts or just for sort of beautiful inspirations, beautiful photography. But I'll just show you the Meandering Shawl as it is in the book. You're not understanding. So there we go. And it is, in the book, it's knit in Madeline Tosh, I think Tosh, is it Tosh Merino Light? Yeah, in Tosh Merino Light, which is a fingering weight single ply yarn. And it's paired with Orkney Angora, a DK 5050 wool Angora yarn, which is amazing. So, yeah, so the pink in this case was the Madeline Tosh and the white with the Angora. And I thought about trying to do something similar, finding maybe not exactly that yarn, but a similar idea, something that's got a halo to it, maybe a mohair yarn to pair it with. But in the end, I had two lovely skeins, which I decided were gonna go together in a project, and they're both Hedgehog Fibers Skinny Singles. So they're both single ply. I really hope I will have enough yardage to finish the project. Might have to improvise at the end and bind off a little early, but these are the two colors that I'm using. Now they are getting a little bit blown out. This, you just, it's got all these beautiful rich jewel tones, as you can see. If you just sort of in your mind bring it just darker, darken it down a bit, but it's almost correct. And this one, and this is showing up pretty much true to life. It's ever, you know, it's a dove gray is the base and all these speckles. These, I'm afraid, were club colorways, so you can't get them. Which I did debate about kind of showing this, but I was like, well, that's what I'm knitting on. I love it. It's beautiful. And to be honest, it's not always true, but Hedgehog Fibers, every time they come up with their club colorways, they come up with so many every month, every year. And it's not that there isn't ever something similar in their line of colorways. Sometimes it's nothing like anything else, but other times there are similarly beautiful, similarly shaded tones, which are part of their regular colorways. So this would work with other yarns. You could get a similar effect, but in love. Anyway, so I haven't done a huge amount of, on this, but you know, and I kind of need to put it on a bigger cable. But yeah, it doesn't have such a contrast when you look at it in real life. Like the camera is making all these colors look like they're very distinct from each other in this yarn. But when you look at it yourself, they look much more blended. So this is one side and this is the other side. And I love brioche knitting. I love two color brioche. I love one color brioche. So I am knitting this on higher sharps. I think they're 3.5 millimeter higher sharps. It's my interchangeable set. So yeah, need a bit more progress to get done on that. But recently I haven't actually picked it up probably for about a week. Too much other knitting going on, but that lives in there. And the other is just a really little project. So recently I knit myself some socks in this beautiful yarn. Damn it, it's also a club colorway. Sorry. This is yarn from Yarn Inc., which I got from her August 2016 club colorway. I don't think it had a name, it was just August 2016. I don't know if she ever adds these then later on as standard colorways, but anyway, this is beautiful. It's like a pale, pale sky blue with all the colors of the rainbow. And I made myself a pair of socks. They're on project page link somewhere, maybe I'll show them another time, with these, with this contrasting yellow mini. This mini I got from Rosie's Moments in the UK, and I called them my sunshine and rainbow socks, and my daughter loves them. And I probably don't have enough of the mini to make them identical, the socks, but at least I'll make, you know, the sock, and then maybe we'll choose a different mini for her heels and toes. So I've got this far on the first sock. To be honest, she doesn't like them very long, so probably the heel's going to get cut in somewhere around here, and I'm not that far off starting the toe. So that's one lovely, beautiful little sock. And yeah, I tend to, well, not always, I enjoy to do short row heels. I have done heel flap and gusset a couple of times for socks, but in general, recently maybe I should say, for striped, self-striping yarn, and when I'm just feeling like I just want a knit, I love the cut-in afterthought heel. So I do have the smooth operator socks pattern from Susan B. Anderson, and I kind of follow her instructions, but I don't put in waste yarn. I just keep knitting, and then I pick up the stitches above and below the row that I want to cut, snip it, pull them out, and then knit the contrast heel that way. There's a wonderful video on YouTube. I never remember it, but the grocery girls are always mentioning it, which shows you exactly how to do that really perfectly, and you never get a gap. And this is living in a project bag from the lovely Mina of the Knitting Expat podcast. I picked this up when she did her Instagram de-stash, beginning of this year, was it? I think it was, yeah. And this was just a bag that she hadn't sold when she did her final Etsy updates, because it had a little mark on the fabric, but I don't care, and I love this grey and light blue stripes, just love it. And it's like, oh, this one here is like soft shirt material or something. Oh, and a turquoise zip. Anyway, love it. So that is everything that I had to show you knitting-wise for this time. Okay, I keep saying this time. I really hope there'll be more times in the future. But I wanted to just show you a couple of things kind of in... It's not Stash and Houseman because it's not yarn, but knitting-related products. So one is, I mentioned already, the Loop book that I got. So this actually is, it's called 10. So it was the pattern book which they released to celebrate 10 years of Loop London. I've never been to Loop in London. I really started knitting properly after I left the UK, although I learned when I was little. And so I've never been, but I do have an aunt who literally lives around the corner from it. So she popped in and got this for me. Total surprise, I had no idea. So I'm very grateful. Grateful for that. And it is really a lovely book. And this pattern here, how's it called? This is called Sprinkle. This is totally on my I want to knit this list. So, you see. It's a beautiful, beautiful cardigan. Probably wouldn't knit it in those exact colours. I mean, I love the grey, actually, to be honest. But probably, I don't know, I can just see it like with a teal colour on the yoke. Oh, anyway. So I really have been loving this book. And you can still see, you can buy it on Ravelry. You can buy the ebook. I'm almost like 99% sure you can buy the ebook. I had a download code to download the ebook when I got with the hard copy. So I'm sure you can also just buy the ebook. And the other thing I wanted to show you is a project bag, which I ordered last week and it already arrived. And this is from, as far as I'm aware, a new bag maker in the UK. She's Jessie Marie Makes. I will link her. I think she just started her Etsy shop, but this I actually bought on Instagram. And I really, really love that print. I just think it's to die for. And I actually purchased two bags, but I can't show you the other one because it's a secret for somebody and I don't want them to see it. They're probably never going to watch this, but I don't want them to see it. Anyway, it has foxes inside. Stunning. I love it. Anyway, I don't think that this bag is interfaced. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't sew much myself. It just doesn't feel like it, but the outer fabric is a canvas. Not like a heavy canvas and, you know, not a wax canvas, but the outer fabric is a canvas, and the inner fabric probably some kind of like cotton, quilting cotton. So it, even by itself, you know, as long as it had something in it, you know, it stands up nicely. So I cannot wait to get a project in there. I almost transferred one of my design projects into here, just so that I could start using it straight away, but I was like, no, it deserves its own project that gets started just for it. I'm crazy, I know. Sorry. Anyway, I'm going to leave it at that for this time. I very much hope I'll be back. I hope someone watches this, maybe likes it, and maybe subscribes. Although I said I can't promise there's going to be any more content. I mean, I do have plans also for some tutorials, knitting tutorials, often that maybe will go with my patterns, not meaning that they will only be available to people who buy the pattern, but that I would make a video to support a pattern, which I would upload. So I have plans to do some of these things in the future. So anyway, if you liked what you saw, then that's great. Let me know. That would be fantastic. You can also comment on the show notes thread, which I will start in my Ravelry group. That's Kingfisher Knits, as I said. I will put a few little links just in the down bar, just so you know where to find me. So even if you don't like or don't use Ravelry, you can still at least see my website and what have you. But I will put the show notes there. And if you have any questions for me or anything you wanted to ask, ideas or something you wanted me to talk about, then I'm also all ears to that. So anyway, I really hope that I will be back soon. It almost certainly will not be before 3 weeks from now, just because I have a trip coming up in a couple of weeks when I'll be away, and I doubt I'll be able to have time to do this again before that. But anyway, I hope you're all having a wonderful time. It is Good Friday today, so I hope everybody has a wonderful Easter weekend. I have no idea when this will be uploaded. So if you're watching this after Easter, I hope you had a great Easter. Bye! So I am back, just about another tiny bit here at the end, just because I think I rushed through one thing that I wanted to say, and it's really important, so I had to put it in, and apologies again, this is my first time. But regarding the Patronus shawl, I really wanted to first make it clear how grateful I am to Tracy for working with me on that collaboration. She is so great to work with, and I really consider her a friend, and I just wanted to say thank you so much, Tracy. I know we speak and all the time on Instagram and by email, but you know, I wanted to sort of thank you face to face. And I also wanted to say a huge thanks to our test knitters for that shawl pattern. So Tracy herself actually did a test knit. She used the Hermione's Otter kit. And then Danny from the Little Bobbins podcast, she test knitted with the Lily and Snape's Doe kit colorway. Really soft, delicate colors. So lovely. Very Danny. And then Katie from the Inside Number 23 podcast chose the Harry and James's Stag, which much higher contrast, is sort of rich mahogany and then a lighter speckled colorway with green and mahogany speckles. And they just all turned out so beautiful. And I'm so very grateful for you for getting involved. And I had to put this in here. I don't know how I forgot in the middle of the podcast. So there we go. Anyway, hope to come back sometime soon. Bye.